All the furniture's on its way to be reupholstered, and now we're gonna start painting.
What do you wanna do here?
I want to mirror it so that it opens this wall up and reflects that window.
One big piece of glass or cut pieces?
I wanna do cut pieces, because then it's a slightly different reflection from each one, which I think is more interesting than solid.
Okay.
And I think that solid can look more like department store. And I wanna paint the shelves, the sides, the top, and this a color, so the mirror also reflects that color.
I like. Let's put these in the van.
This is what I'm worried about. I don't know what's involved. This is a major redo.
Yeah.
Brian thinks that this is just a quick reupholstery, so that's the way it has to remain, the definition of it. But is it a rebuild?
Well, some of the springs are broken.
Okay. I hope they know how to, wow. I feel naked. Is there someone behind that chair? What are you doing?
I have a box of goodies that I think we should look at.
Okay. A box of my goodies?
Well, yeah. You know how you were like, maybe coral or turquoise.
Uh-huh.
But look how we can see how these things all look.
Right.
And then look at this.
Choosing color is difficult. I think because I'm a makeup artist, I probably am more knowledgeable about color than most. But color is intimidating, and so I look for inspiration for the bookshelf from objects that I have collected. Yeah. It's a great idea, yeah. And this is in that same world. The dark color of the wall, to me, is a neutral. So just the tones of the wall looked better with the deeper tone of orange. If you can tell, then high gloss is like shiny as we can get it, like the space. That'd be great, I think.
Okay, perfect.
Debbie and I are going to Dwight's auction to hopefully find some cool things for Steamboat so I can further be in financial ruin.
Oh, you bought that look?
Yeah, just something simple. I love coming here, first because I get to watch Dwight at work, and you never know what you're gonna find. That's a cute little floor lamp. I've had my eye on a floor lamp, and it sort of reminds me of Paris. It sort of reminds me of New Orleans. It sort of reminds me of John Dudley. I don't know, I just felt drawn to it and I had to have it.
If he calls it John Dudley, I'm gonna die.
If somebody liked copper, those are more.
I think it's wacky and cool, just like Billy. So I think it'll look great in his house. He doesn't have anything like that.
Brian's gonna die, but it's fine. What did I pay for it,
$900?
No, he's gonna have a bet. Coming up.
I'm calling on behalf of Save Aberdeen Landmarks.
We try and raise enough money to save the five and dime. Mom, I'm buying you a ticket to the Wynonna Judd thing.
Thank you. What do you want for supper? You want supper tonight?
And later, Wynonna finally arrives. Here, may I?
Yes, you may. You've earned the right.
John Dudley's cutting 6 inches off every section of the couch. Then he's going to resize the ends to fit the new dimensions. So we've got to figure out how to make this pile of wood into a sofa. My idea is the batting would go on the front, sort of tapered down. The backs, I think, would be tufted, covered buttons. The pillow on the top, we would pipe in black. I want it to look traditionally sort of opulent.
Plain, but fancy.
Right, more contemporary than what they traditionally looked like, and not like Zsa Zsa Gabor's bedroom in Beverly Hills.
That'd be no problem.
I love when you say no problem, because I have this huge event on Tuesday that's going to completely take up my time. Do you think we can get it done by then?
We're going to have to pull in some overtime to get that done.
All right. My old furniture's just arrived from the upholsterers, and I can't wait to see it.
I hope you don't get mad. I decided not to do the stripes, and I picked this out instead.
Oh, you did a seashell slipcover?
Want to see?
Yeah. Wow.
Looks nice.
Wow. That old couch cleaned up pretty good. Look at that. What do you think?
Don't get your dirty feet on it.
Yes. Oh, look at that little yard sale chair.
Look at that.
Wow. Do you remember what this looked like?
Yeah,
he had some good naps on this couch, the way that it was.
Yeah, it's a little lumpy, I'm not gonna lie, but I sit on it, but I'm dirty.
Well, you know what? It's indoor-outdoor fabric.
It is indoor.
It's very hardy fabric.
So I can sit on it?
Well. Hey, Marsha. Tonight is a telethon to sell tickets to the Five and Dime Wynonna event. So far, we've sold a whopping 38 tickets, so we have a lot to sell tonight. And if we don't fill up that house, I have no idea how we're gonna save the building. We have our, our celebrity telethon phone callers I'd like to introduce.
Right.
First, we have Marsha Ballard, the number one realtor in Monroe County, fabulous Debbie Stubblefield, decorator to the stars, my personal decorator, and caterer to all weddings.
That's right.
And all bar mitzvahs. Patsy Claxton of librarian fame, when I was in what grade?
5th and 6th.
I was terrified of her. Hey, just for the record,
what?
I've not used a telephone book in about 20 years. Is this really the way we do it down here?
It's the way.
I don't even know if I'm delivered a phone book in New York anymore. I didn't know they had them. I thought it was like a rotary dial phone.
Save Aberdeen Landmarks.
I'm calling on behalf of Save Aberdeen Landmarks.
I was calling about our benefit.
Our exciting event and evening with Wynonna.
It's a meet and greet with her.
For a gorgeous catered 5-course meal.
Just wanted to call and see if you could help support us.
Would love to attend.
You're great.
Yay! Mom?
Yeah?
I'm buying you a ticket to the Wynonna Judd thing.
Thank you. What do you want for supper? You want supper tonight?
That'll be great. Thank you so much. Okay.
$200
ticket.
Yay!
We would, I guess, or commit to $2,000.
Oh, wow.
Great.
Count the ones that Dwight and Miss Houston sold today.
We sold all the tickets, and I am so excited.
One.
Yay! Coming up, I go to the auction house with Lori.
It's very, like, contagious, the energy here. You just want to bid, 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 bid.
And later, the Wynonna event is a great success. We'll be right back. The renovations on Steamboat are coming along great. Allison's working on the bookcase, and we're painting the floor this beautiful light gray.
So I feel like we need to place them to make sure that we're going to get them just right. I mean, we know there's one that's going to be in the middle.
I'm going to mirror and paint an accent color. So the mirrors will reflect that color. And then it's going to mirror the windows from the other side. In essence, bring a window to a windowless wall.
I think once we get them spaced out, we need to start with the center one, put some glue on. It's not a cupcake, Billy. Come on.
Yeah. Magic. Instant glamour.
Look at that.
John Dudley, let's see if you look taller.
Well, depends on how
you look shorter.
Yeah, he does.
I'm on my tiptoes, I'm kidding.
From my angle, it chops his neck off and it looks like your head's
your
sitting on your
shoulder. Your neck's chopped off and looks like it's on your shoulders.
Ooh. Ooh. It's sad that we're entertained by this at our age.
Really yeah. Expands the space.
You're catching on, John.
Yeah, you are catching
I'm
on.
I'm trying.
Yeah,
before you know it.
A little junior designer badge.
I know, or at the very least gay. You want to put a rug down?
Yeah.
Okay, stop. All right. The floors are painted and dry, and so I can finally bring in the rug and start arranging the furniture.
The striped sofa is going to look great on this rug.
Out here, to the edge of the carpet.
Bye.
Wait, to the edge of the carpet?
You guys have no decorating scent.
Well, that's what you're
about right there, where the feet are on the edge of the carpet. It's opposites attract. I just love the way that this high style black and white stripe couch looks on this natural rug.
I get this layout, but I just feel like it's not very intimate. This chair is 20 feet from the sofa.
I get what you're saying about more intimate, and the thing about it is this could be nice in front, you know, actually facing the mantel. I have moved furniture around since I was 7 and 8 years old. I've had a lot of practice. So I try and think of what it looks like from every direction. What feels comfortable? What feels inviting?
I like what I see. If you're right here now, you can look at the front.
Right.
You can look at your guests who are seated here, or even if they're at your big sofa that's gonna be there.
I can yell at John Dudley from this perspective too. It's pretty good.
Yeah, it is.
This is all open and this defines the space. This is now your living room.
Right.
It's very good.
It's good. The John Dudley is home. He's huge. The John Dudley lamp that I bought at the auction is finally home. I want to see how tall it looks up here.
Billy.
What? Is it too tall?
It's too a lot of things.
It's so good. John Dudley, get over there and let's see how much she
it
looks like.
Have a
I love it up there.
It's just my height.
Look, it looks just like you.
You just need to play
some flutes.
There you go. Oh, I don't care if somebody likes it or not. I mean, I know it's a little bit over the top, but I mean, I love it. And I am certain the John Dudley floor lamp is absolutely supposed to be in this house.
It's a sweet lamp.
You should be very flattered, John.
I am.